Hello guys, this is Abhay Sharma for Thinking Penguin and welcome to my YouTube channel. This video is just a minor update of the previous tutorial that I did for Fusion, how to create the long shadow effect. And a few nice people have suggested me to use the directional blur node instead of a normal blur node, which will simplify the process and make it less complicated. But actually I have already mentioned in my tutorial that this effect can be achieved with the other nodes as well, like directional blur node and the raise node, but I didn't demonstrate it, so I thought let me show you why I did not use the directional blur node. So one of the biggest reason for that is I did not use directional blur node is because it's very compute intensive. Let me show you. It's a bigger text, so I'm going with a very normal text. Just type TP. I'm gonna increase the size a little bit, right? Okay, now let's apply directional blur. Okay, I'm gonna change the angle to 45 degrees, and you can see we have the blur. Now let's assign the channel boolean tool. So now this channel boolean, 2D boolean, not 3D boolean. Okay, and change the operation to divide. All right, and let's take a background node to control the color of the shadow. I'm gonna change the shadow to something like this. Okay, let's merge it with the text. I'm gonna toggle the inputs by pressing the Ctrl plus T key. Okay, now you have created similar effect, you can see. Let me create a background. Okay, and let's change the background color to something bright. Alright, so you can see that you can achieve the same effect with the directional blur node as well. But the problem is its shadow is inside the composition. Shadow has to be outside the composition for this effect to look nice. So what I'll do is I'll change the length. So let's say 0.4. And as you can see, it's taking time and it's still in the composition bounds. So I'll change it to 0.5. Okay, so you can see we have achieve the same effect with directional blur node with less nodes as well, you know, but this is not as responsive as this effect. Let me show you the difference. If I select the blur node and try to change the angle, you can see the feedback is very slow. It's not very responsive. But let me show you the other node. And now if I change the angle, you can see the feedback is almost instantaneous. And that's the reason why I did not use the directional blur node. Okay, so sometimes you just need the effect, right? You don't care about how much time it's gonna take. If you're working on a simple project, this effect can be used. As you can see, it's not gonna take significant time actually. But if you're working on a complex project, then I would suggest to use a setup like this, or use a raise node if you have a graphics card which supports OpenCL, which will be much more faster. But yeah, so this is the reason why I did not use the directional blur node. But you can use it if you want it. The choice is yours. Alright guys, thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.